Well, it's been 1 year since Cyberpunk launched, on the fateful day that is my birthday. Alright, well this is gonna be a fun one, so you just go on ahead and get comfy, make sure to lay down beside the pillow, not on it, that'd be ridiculous, and prepare to dive back into one of the buggiest games ever created by the company everybody seemed to respect. Anyways, before I really dive in, shameless plug, follow me over on Twitter. I post lots of game stuff, life stuff, and honestly, it helps my content get out there.
But basically nobody knows I actually have a Twitter.
So Cyberpunk 2077, the game not lost in time, but in bugs, and glitches, and problems. The second worst game launch I have ever experienced, only second to Fallout 76, cause Well, last year I reviewed Cyberpunk for what the actual game content was, not the bugs, but this year we're gonna flip that around and only focus on the problems, cause that was one of the only reasons why people put it down a year ago and haven't bothered with it since. The big question that most of you want to know is if the game is even worth trying again, and I'd say that it's getting there. It's still not the most polished experience, at least after that 5-hour intro. When I was replaying through that absolute grind of an intro, I was thinking, dang, they really cleaned this game up. But immediately after I exited that area, things started to get crazy. It was almost like the intro area is a separate game, because once you get out of there, the game just ends up having most of the same problems. It's better than it used to be, but not by much. The bugs and quests pick up tenfold. Even though the story is supposed to get more intense and dark, the glitches just make it comedy. Going to rescue a kidnapped friend who's in serious danger, breaks enemy's neck through a wall, guy walks through a door frame, customers walking around in a restricted area, advanced stand-up desk. Actually, this guy gets bonus points because he was eating a whole pizza by himself. I mean, I'm sure games are gonna have their problems, but holy does that take you out of the moment. That mission was a pretty good summary of how other missions went post-intro. Just the typical bugs, glitches, enemies sometimes wouldn't spawn in. The list could absolutely go on, but at some point you gotta wonder, can you? The missions are great, very well-told stories, but when the story is completely ruined by a bunch of things that aren't supposed to be happening, it ruins it entirely. However, it's not all bad, my good people. The game has definitely polished up a ton of the bugs that plagued the game for quite some time. They patched up heaps of those sharp edges that would just launch a character into the stratosphere. They fixed a ton of the problems with weapons being all broken or quests entirely breaking without any way to finish them, especially the ones that would completely shatter or when you'd approach them from a different angle, not through the front gate. Through my most recent playthrough, I didn't encounter a single quest that I could not finish. Even with the characters bugging out or insanely broken stuff happening, they were still completable. Well, regardless, the game is way more playable now, still in a state where I'm sure people would be upset if it launched, cause it's not perfect, but you can at least do your stuff. In terms of added stuff, or maybe I should say reworks or something, there hasn't been much besides two major systems. Driving and police. Driving now actually feels like driving, and you're not a remote controlled brick, so that's great. It makes all those cop chases more enjoyable, right? Get it? Cause there aren't any. The police rework wasn't at all what we expected. It was more like they fixed them literally teleporting on you when you'd shoot them, and they're still not perfect. I had one cop spawn inside my moving car somehow, which was actually hilarious. But besides that, it doesn't change much. Essentially, this game has got the worst wanted system for an open world shooter, since all the chases are scripted events, so there aren't any outside of story missions. The 4-star cop chase, it's not a challenge like the GTA 5-star, by the way. The first 3 stars are like, LOL dude, stop, don't kill all those innocent people. But all you do is add 1 more star and they're like, oh look at that, you're dead. Basically, if you wanted to come back to the game and live out your dreams of being a super wanted cyber criminal running from the cops, yeah, you're not gonna get that. Now, as of this video, I've played fully through the game 4 times, 3 of those times unable to complete most of the quests because they were bugged, but my 4th time, I actually did everything in the game without breaking. I mean, it was still an insanely buggy playthrough, but way better than the others. And after going through the game that many times, there's one thing I really started to notice. How much of an RPG this game wants to be, but how much it is not an RPG by any stretch of the imagination. Heaps of quests contain dialogue I had never heard until my 4th playthrough. There's so many things you can say that will throw all the other options in the trash the moment you choose it, so you'll never fully hear all a character has to say unless you save before every conversation or just replay the game in a different way.
You can go back and play Doctor once you're done with us.
So in the past, on max difficulty, it would be the equivalent of saying, oh man, don't try this sauce, it's crazy spicy. and then it's milk. Now when I go back to play, since I got used to baby mode, I was constantly dying because the enemies are actually aggressive, take advantage over cover way better, and they hit their shots. One break in intermission, I decided to just speedrun it. Well, it turns out there was an NPC on a speedrun to kill me. This dude just comes barreling in from the staircase I just came up and blasts me dead in a second. Now, this isn't to say the game is nonstop brutal, because depending on your build, you can still absolutely destroy everything immediately by the time level 20 rolls around. But you know, as we're talking about enemies and AI, why don't we talk about the greatest of AI, the pedestrians. They're beyond sophisticated. They walk, act, and ooze personality and understanding. Every moment around them is like sipping on a fine wine. They create a living, breathing environment that feels realistic and immersive. It pains me to remember that this game was originally supposed to have some sort of RPG realistic civilians with their daily schedules, jobs, homes, friends, etc.
The city's streets are bustling with crowds of people from all facets of life, all living their lives within a full day and night cycle.
This guy right here? Oh, he's just coming home from a long day at work. Just kidding, he's going back to work. The most you can interact with these civilians is either mowing them down like overgrown weeds, or by scanning them and going, "Ah, yes, you person, very cool." But come on, Watch Dogs civilians might not have been essential either, but you could hack anyone's phone, see their ID, job income, read their texts, listen to their messages, even though they didn't matter at all. The more I play Cyberpunk, the more I turn down the volume of civilian population, because it doesn't populate the roads with cars like I wanted it to, it just clones everyone on the street and calls it a day. They might be some of the most insanely detailed looking civilians I have ever seen, but don't be fooled, these guys have no brains. Now let's talk about something good. The more you play, the more you start to notice how amazing the details of the world are. This game has literally every room you enter detailed up to the last corner. The world around you is absolutely massive and is vibrant, still one of the best video game cities ever made, definitely up there with the likes of Los Santos, San Francisco, and Arkham City. It's an incredibly well-made world. Sure, it's mostly empty of any sort of interaction, but this map, not you, is visually stunning. And then the cars. Oh man, it kills me that the car system is so beyond lazy in this game, because you cannot convince me that any other game has done car designs better. And yes, I did compare them to GTA. These designs whoop GTA car designs, especially for fictional vehicles. The interiors are something else. Each car you get into, it feels like a real life car, but it also feels drastically different from any other. There's no two cars that feel the same. The vehicle sounds, the exterior designs. This is exactly what we wanted from cyberpunk-esque vehicles. But then the system, of course, falls flat when you can't just steal and then claim a purple version of the car you have, but only in red. There's no garage for customization, and in the end, besides looking cool, these cars, they just don't matter. But you know, I just can't wait for that online cyberpunk mode when it comes out. It's gonna be better than GTA Online. We'll be able to, you know, fully customize our cars and our guns and apartments. Wow, I sure can't wait for that to definitely happen soon. Please. And the combat. I don't understand why so many people hate the combat with a passion, because I love it. It's not some perfected modern warfare stuff, but for an open world action game, it's pretty dang smooth. And for an FPS, it's got better gameplay than that new Battlefield does. There's tons of different weapons to choose from, tons of guns that can have multiple ways on how you use them. The only thing that lacks is the customization. You know, there's a couple things you can just slap on, but it would be nice to see some gun building as you played more into the game. But personally, I really enjoy the gunplay in combat. It's one of the main reasons I go back and replay the game. The thing is, Cyberpunk is a way better experience now than it was a year ago. The story and gameplay is so much better, the open world is very fun to explore, and nowadays, it doesn't usually immediately kill you for exploring outside the boundaries. The soundtrack is one of the best out there. I mean, even if you don't want to play the game, just listen to the music, because it's so good, it's just... Cyberpunk is a genuinely good game, strangled by the fact that it launched early, I'm sure receiving many lawsuits from Disney as it very closely resembled but it's getting cleaned up. I think the only other problem I had is if they had launched the game, explained a little bit more what the game was, that it wasn't actually an RPG, that clarity probably would have gone a long way. People didn't expect Cyberpunk to be pretty much anything it is due to the built-up hopes and then eventual lies, and folks aren't going to just start accepting that. I don't go out and buy a box of mini wheats and just expect to open it up to a box of cornflakes. So, at the end of all of this, my final verdict, my big review, is that mini-wheats are a 10 out of 10 cereal, a true revolution in the industry, and a pinnacle of standards.